Want a bird more? I brought up a couple things. I'll take 5 minutes and quickly go down. Yeah. If you really want to bring more birds in, it's really super easy. You just need a water source. I've seen eagles. I just saw two kestrels in my backyard. I've seen blue herons in my pond. It is super easy to bring in birds. For cover, you mentioned cover. I noticed my hummingbirds love to nest in red bud. This will be full-on red flowers in about 2 weeks. Also, they like this one. This is a, I noticed my sparrows. A lot of my smaller birds love flowering pear. So that's a Bradford pear. Those are great trees. You'll always see nests in those particular trees, constantly. Some of the flowers they love to have, the pollinators. This is gopher perch. Gopher plant. It's supposed to keep gophers away from your garden. Now, it's just a pretty plant that looks prehistoric, but great for pollinators, butterflies, hummingbirds. It brings the wildlife in. This one's a winter bloomer. Your bees and your early migrators will use this because it's one of the few things that's in bloom. This and rosemary, they bring those. Rosemary, lavender are great early season pollinators. Easy, you plant some of these, you will find wildlife in your yard. I mean, from monarchs to swallowtails. I use this one a lot in my own garden to attract birds. This is a sedum, but this specific one is called autumn joy sedum. I notice my really small birds, when there's not a lot of weeds and stuff out yet, they'll use this as a food source. They'll peck the leaves off. I go, I'm okay with that, because eventually there's enough other bugs and insects for them to eat. Then they let this, the pressure's off, they start to let it grow again. But it's a great plant for bringing in specifically birds into your gardens. Isn't that pretty? This is rhododendron. It's just a pretty early bloomer that's a good shade plant. You need something bright in the shade areas, a good pollinator. Another one I love for my butterflies and hummingbirds, I use this in containers quite a bit. This is Abelia. Has a little pink flower on it, it's very fragrant. It blooms basically from April through fall. So we want to keep the butterflies and things coming, that's the way to do it. And I'll leave it with this. There's some natives, I've got silverberry, the most fragrant native you will ever find. Evergreen shrub, it's about this tall or this wide. It puts red-tipped photinia to shame. And it's native, whereas red-tip is not. So very, very fragrant plant. The birds love nesting in that. Lastly, I'll leave it with the yellow one, and I could keep going on and on, but we're wrapping this thing up. Forsythia just opened up. So that's the one that announces that yellow bush in the back. That's the one that announces spring. The birds love it.